In this screencast, we're going to go through a process design example, specifically looking at heuristics or rules of thumb. And these are things that you typically follow when you're going through designing your process. And there's one in particular that I want to do an example on. In the Product and Process Design Principles book, we're specifically going to look at heuristic 38, which states that for liquid flow, we're going to assume a pipeline change in pressure of 2 psi per 100 feet of pipe, and a change in pressure of at least 10 psi for each control valve. Also, for each 10-foot rise in elevation, we're also going to assume a change in pressure of 4 psi. So let's look at a specific problem where we're going to demonstrate using this rule of thumb. We have a processing plant that needs to pump liquid from a storage tank at a lower elevation to a heating tank at a higher elevation. We want the pump to be placed at the outlet of the storage tank, and this is going to move the fluid to the heating tank. Now, there's certain design requirements that we need to match, and we're given a pump curve for the pump that we're going to use. So first and foremost, we're given information about the pressure at the inlet of the pump, as well as the pressure that is necessary to enter the heating tank. We're also told what the required flow rate needs to be, that there's one control valve between the pump and the heating tank, and of the elevation change. Given this information, we're interested in using heuristic 38 to determine an estimated maximum length of pipe in feet that we can install between the pump and the heating tank. The last bit of information you're going to need is the pump curve, so let's show that for this pump. So go ahead and try to do this on your own, and then we'll set it up and work through it. So a pump curve will give you an idea of what the head pressure will be at any given flow rate. In this problem statement, we were interested in a flow rate of 30 gallons per minute, which means the maximum pressure head that we could accomplish with this pump is about 43 psi. Now typically on a pump curve, the head is going to be in feet or meters. Here we've designated it in psi so we could directly read off of this chart. Let's draw a picture for our process so that we could map this out and determine the maximum length of piping. Now we're told we have some kind of storage tank at a lower elevation than our heater. We're also told that there's some kind of pump right out the outlet of the tank, and that the pressure at this outlet is 9 psi, and the pressure into the tank is 10 psi. We're also told that there's one valve somewhere in our line, and with our heuristic, this has a delta P associated with it as 10 psi. So at this point, we're going to do a pressure balance to determine the maximum length that this pipe can be. We know that our initial pressure is 9 psi, and to that, we're going to add a pump pressure of 43 psi. That's our maximum head that we could produce from the pump given the flow rate. Now both of these pressures are positive because of what we're starting with and what we're adding to the system. We're going to subtract out what we're finishing with, which is the pressure of the heater, which is 10 psi. Then we're also going to subtract out the losses due to the valve, which is 10 psi. We're also going to subtract out the losses due to elevation, which I'll designate delta P elevation. Based on our heuristic, our losses associated with the elevation are 4 psi per 10 foot of elevation change. Since we're going up, these are going to be lost. And then lastly, we're going to subtract out our delta P of the length of the pipe, which also has a relationship. Delta P is 2 psi per 100 feet of pipe. So I've highlighted the terms that we are going to work with. A simplified form of this equation looks like the following, where we have the initial pressure in the tank plus the pressure produced by the pump, and we're subtracting out the pressure of the heater as well as all of the pressures due to losses. So we have 9 psi plus 43 psi minus 10 minus 10 minus 26, and then minus our variable of interest, which is going to be our L times 2 over 100. And this is going to be equal to 0. We're left with 6 psi is equal to L times 2 over 100. This means that our L is going to be 300 feet. So for this problem, our estimated maximum length of the pipe is going to be 300 feet, given our pump capacity and the losses associated with the components in the system.